Wow, it's hard to believe. It's a little bit more than 5 weeks since the guys started breaking down the rock cliffs on our final edge of Montagne Mar. Hi guys, you're here with Barry and DR, and I wanted to drive out here since I got a call from Agapito about they're almost finished, and he said it's a pretty good day, come on out and have a look. I want you guys to take a look at this panoramic view here, and hopefully you can gather an appreciation. If you go back to the prior film that we did on our project update sometime in June, about roughly 4 weeks ago, you'll find out that this was all mountain and jagged, and everything needed to be done. We just were in the midst of doing it back then, and the machines were out working away, the bulldozers and what have you. And what you're looking at is a lot of caliche, like tons of material. I don't know if you appreciate how much material it takes to make platforms of this size for home foundations. But in any event, have a look at this and you'll get to appreciate the amount of work that goes into this. There's old Aggie there with his truck, and they're doing the final stages back there on a little section there where the power chisel is. I'll drive up there later, but I wanted to do first a panoramic view to get an idea of how much material goes into this. Now remember, about a month ago, this was all jagged rock, okay? So we were breaking this all down, leveling it. We're not finished the compacting part of it yet, but as I'm driving into this, I was really surprised, and I took a film of it on the old video when I had it mounted on the truck earlier. As I came up, I was blown away at what was done here compared to a month ago. I'll tell you, if you only knew how much work this was to break this jagged stuff down, and we're using a lot of the fill, as well as what's coming out of Agapito's caliche mine. And that gives you an idea of the size of this, okay, as I'm driving through it here. It is an enormous amount of work. But what it does do is yield second to none in terms of the best possible views that are over 180 degrees wide. This section here, actually, it's all subjective, so I'm not, but in my tastes, this is the best little section I think we've seen to date. The reason being is on one side of it is complete ocean and valley views, which will never be built on. It's all farmland, and that's its highest and best use. And when you circle around, like I'm about to do with the truck right now, as I circle around, everything in the back of it, okay, which would be just beautifully lit up during the morning when the sun's coming up in the east, all of it is mountain. And part of it is like a semi-type rainforest. So I'm just driving over the compacted areas right now. And like I say, in about 5 weeks' time from jagged mountains to near ready for home foundations, what's left is we're going to, as with all of the lots in Montagne Mar, we are going to be making private road, private drive entrances to each lot. That's also very unique about the project. We've still got to put in the electric into this area. Actually, I'm going through some permitting with it right now with Manuel. I will be, we will be adding the water tubing to each individual lot. Now, I'll be up here over the next 2 weeks doing the highest and best use on subdivides. From doing it for for so much of my life, I can tell there's going to be three nice sized lots up here. Each will be unobtrusive to the others, which is excellent. And we're coming in now. You'll see one of the power chisels is finishing a certain area there, just kind of looking around, making sure everything's as ordered the way they want it. And real soon we'll be coming in with the bulldozers to pack it down even further. And what works great with caliche is good rains. When rain comes, which we're scheduled to get, and actually, when I'm recording this, we just got a good dose over the weekend. But that was after I had filmed this. I wanted to get out before the weather turned for the weekend. But with caliche, when it rains, it does pack it as well. So we like to let it have two or three good hard rains on it before we even start running the bulldozer treads over it to pack it down. But just giving you one last drive around on a panoramic about how much work went in over the last 5 weeks. When I tell you, I think we got a great crew. Of course, I'm going to be leaning towards it. I'm part of it, but we've got a great team of guys. These guys, you're going to see a little later because I'm going to continue on to some of the other sections where I've had folks, okay, granted that they live in flatland, but they were saying there's no way you put roads in that. Well, we're starting another one that's going to yield two other plateau lots. These plateau lots will not have view in both directions. Of course, they're going to have unobstructed ocean view, but I'm heading out now. I'm going to leave this part of the project and come on along with us. And we're going to head out to a couple of the other sections of the Montagne Mar project. But I've got to tell you, my gosh, what a difference. You almost have to be here to appreciate it. It is quite magnificent. I'm heading out on the exit road now to the main entrance of the project. And there's been a lot of progress going on. There is another home that'll be breaking ground over the next couple of weeks. They're doing their final adjustments with the contractor, and they should be breaking ground, I would say, within 2 to 3 weeks from what I understand. Not that I get involved with it, but I do, you know, that people tell me what's going on and the contractor will talk with me. And a lot of times the contractor wants to know, like, okay, where's the underground cable and where's the water, and to you know, better do his type, his responsibilities. But what I'm going to do here is all these lots now, I'm going to giddy up a little bit more with Yoda, but all these lots here that, are to the right of camera right now. They've all been sold. There's Canadian folks. There's actually folks from my home province, Alberta. Two of them actually, from Alberta. Folks from the States. And we're going to meet up with the main road here. We're going to be leaving this very natural on the left side. The partners own that section there. And if people in this area decide they would like to do some, you know, crops and fruits and vegetables, and they want to till it, and they want to maybe even put in a stable for horseback riding, or they want to raise a few cows and goats and things, we're going to make that available at a really reasonable price if they all want to chip in and get into it to that degree. But circling around here, I'm heading up towards the main entrance of the project, which many of you have seen several times before. Of course, to the left is the judge's ramp to go to his house. And as a matter of fact, we got some good folks staying there a little bit later in July that are here for 5 days to take one of our tours with us, and I'm sure they'll enjoy it. But as I come down the main chute here, I'm going to bear left. The electric is all finished in this area and what have you. Water's all in these other two areas. But as I circle around, I'm going to stop at one of the next constructions that we showed you a month ago, just in its just again, you'll have to go back to the video to see how much progress they made in a month. And use this to your discretion also to understand about how things actually do get done very quickly, relatively speaking. Time-wise, if you're using good contractors and reputable people and all your permits are in place, time to build is on par with anything that's in America. Okay, so this home, we showed you the basics of it. This is a retired architect from the capital who's going to be coming here eventually full time. But for now, what I understand, and it is secondhand information, he'll be here using it as his country house. It's going to be quite an elaborate country house, but that's about 1 month's progress from when I last filmed it, when they were just digging out the foundation. I'm going to head on down the road a little bit further here into section two, what we call. And just prior to entering it, or just post entering it, excuse me, just after entering it, there's an American couple there building their home, which again, you could look at 1 month prior and get a good idea of the amount of progress done in about a month. And you'll see anybody who's built homes in Canada, where I'm from, or America, you'll find out they're pretty close to being on par in terms of time. So they're building up their little house there, and I'm going to hug the road as it goes around their property. Not one, but two lots after that is where they're going to be breaking ground in about 3 weeks. I'm going to pull in, and you can see in the forefront on the camera there a bunch of white rock going to the left. I want to purposely pull in there. There's nowhere for me to go. I'm just going to aim camera in there because we just started roughing it in. Okay, but this is where people were saying that, no, there's no, you don't do that. It can't be. Well, we do it all the time. Once they're cemented or asphalted, they're perfectly passable by a compact car. So I'm just going to pull in here to give you a better idea. There's going to be two more lots going up on a plateau, which is going to make for a nice, certainly a beautiful panoramic view for people. And we'll keep you posted as that road gets finished and the extra lots that go in there. Of course, probably 1 to 2 more videos. I'll be able to drive up there and give you guys a little bit of a grand tour as to what's going on. They'll be breaking ground on this lot where the big backhoe shovel is in the next 3 weeks, hopefully. And I want to drive up the hill here. This is past old Gary's lot here, and we're coming up the hill. And this old Jerry and Nancy, they're putting in the privacy wall now. Jerry and Nancy are already living here. They're not here full time, but whenever they do come in here, it's all fully furnished, it's fully functional, but they're adding in their privacy wall and various other things like that, and it is coming around really well. That's the garage. They have a single car with side space for storage, all the foundation, the driveways. They're putting in foliage and a privacy wall. Like I say, it's all fully functional, fully furnished. We're going to do another interview with them when they come here from their house, because they were actually quite astounded. They only came here twice during the whole construction and were evidently extremely pleased with the way things came out. So until next time, this is Barry for Something Feels Wrong. We'll talk to you soon. Bye.